Cannabidiol for treatment of epilepsy. Cannabidiol is coming from the species Cannabis. This cannabis plant is also well known under the name Marihuana. And this cannabis plant is also known with another name Hemp. This plant contains so many compounds which are commonly called as cannabinoids. These cannabinoids are psychoactive compounds, but among them, cannabidiol is one of the useful drugs in the treatment of epilepsy. So in this video, let us see how this cannabidiol acts on the cannabinoid receptors and other types of drug targets and how it can show its anti-epileptic activity. And it is coming from the cannabis species, and particularly cannabis sativa is one of the important sources of this cannabinoids. And this cannabis species contains so many number of compounds. Among them, the two important compounds are cannabidiol as well as the tetrahydrocannabinol. Cannabidiol can act as an anxiolytic as well as anti-epileptic compound, whereas tetrahydrocannabinol is a psychoactive compound resulting in the hallucinations and other psychoactive symptoms. Now let us see the cannabidiol as well as the tetrahydrocannabinol. So this is the structure of the cannabidiol, and this is the structure of the tetrahydrocannabinol. And we can observe that the ring is closed in the tetrahydrocannabinol and it is open in the cannabidiol. So these are the two important components which are present in the cannabis species, but among them, cannabidiol is nowadays therapeutically useful as an anti-epileptic drug. Multiple actions of cannabinoids. Cannabinoids can show analgesic activity, anti-epileptic activity, anxiolytic activity, antioxidant activity, as well as muscle relaxant activity. So these compounds proved to show so many important actions. They also proved as neuroprotective agents, and they can also be proved beneficial in few of the disorders like multiple sclerosis. And even these drugs act by multiple mechanisms. So cannabidiol is one of the drug which is therapeutically used, and this drug can show its action on the so many types of receptors as well as the targets. So one of the important one is that it is going to inhibit the cannabinoid receptor, CB receptors, by which it can show the anxiolytic as well as the analgesic activity. And this drug can also block the TRP1 channels, which are the ion channels responsible for the neuronal excitation. CBD can also increase the 5-HT1A or 2A receptor activity, thereby it can also control the neurotransmission. And apart from these actions, cannabidiol can show a multiple mechanisms. It can block the calcium channels which are responsible for the neurotransmission, as well as it can increase the reactive oxygen species, and it can inhibit the mTOR signaling, and it can also inhibit the uptake of norepinephrine, anandamide, as well as other types of neurotransmitters. So cannabidiol can have the multiple targets, and thereby it shows a multiple pharmacological actions. But one of their important action is on the cannabinoid receptors. Now let us see how it going to be act on the cannabinoid receptors. We can have the two types of cannabinoid receptors, CB1 receptors and CB2 receptors. CB1 receptors are mainly present in the central neurons as well as in the peripheral neurons. They are responsible for the neuronal excitation. And CB2 receptors are mainly present on the immune cells like the lymphoid tissue, as well as spleen and leukocytes. So CB2 receptors are mainly confined to the peripheral immune system. Of course, few of the CB2 receptors are also found in few of the neurons, but their main role is on the peripheral immune cells. Now this cannabidiol can block this CB1 receptors as well as the CB2 receptors. By blocking the CB1 receptors, it mainly shows the analgesic as well as the anxiolytic activity. And another component in this cannabis, that is the THC, can act as a partial agonist on the CB2 receptors. Because of its partial agonist activity, THC can show some psychotomimetic effects like hallucinations and delusions in the patients. Cannabidiol, which is not an agonist but is an antagonist on these receptors, is not showing these psychotomimetic effects, thereby free of hallucinations, delusions and other psychoactive symptoms. Now let us see anti-epileptic action of the CBD. Just we have seen that the cannabidiol is going to block the CB1 receptor, thereby it shows the anxiolytic as well as analgesic activity. But its antiepileptic activity is not attributed to the action on the CB1 receptors. But this cannabidiol can act on the other targets by which it can show the antiepileptic activity. Epilepsy is a neuronal disorder in which a high frequency of neuronal discharge can lead to the epilepsy. So on the neurons, various targets are present which can increase the neurotransmission, thereby they can produce the epilepsy. So one of such target is the TRPV1 channels through which the calcium can enter into the neuronal cells. And another target is the G protein coupled receptor 55, which can also increase the intracellular release of the calcium. And neurons can also be equipped with the 5-HT1A receptors, which are auto-inhibitory in nature, which actually prevent the neurotransmission. Now, when these TRPV1 channels are activated, calcium is entered into the neuronal cells, which lead to the stimulation of the neurotransmission, as well as GPR55 receptors can also increase the intracellular calcium release, which also increase the neurotransmission. But when 5-HT1A receptors are activated, because they are auto-inhibitory in nature, they can prevent the neurotransmission. In this way, neurotransmission can be controlled by 5-HT1A receptors, and it can be increased by TRPV1 as well as GPR55 receptors. Now this cannabidiol can affect this neurotransmission by acting on all these targets. Cannabidiol can block this TRPV1 channels, thereby inhibit the neurotransmission, and it can also block the GPR55 receptors, but at the same time it can stimulate the 5-HT1A receptor by acting like an agonist, thereby it inhibits the neurotransmission. Because of all these actions, cannabidiol can show its anti-epileptic activity. And apart from these actions, cannabidiol can also show effects on the other neurotransmitters, thereby it can also control the epilepsy. Side effects. So already we have seen that cannabidiol is having no psychomimetic effects like the THC, because it is not acting on the CB2 receptors as agonist, instead acting as an antagonist. So it is free of such side effects, but it can produce the some mild side effects like drowsiness, lethargy, sedation, insomnia, chills, and fever in the patients. Clinical uses. Cannabidiol can be used in the treatment of epilepsy, as well as it can also be used in the other conditions like the anxiety, and it can also be used as an analgesic and for treatment of dystonias and in the multiple sclerosis. Even it can be used for all these conditions, the safety of this cannabidiol is established in the treatment of epilepsy. So currently it is preferred for the treatment of the epilepsy. So where it is used in the epilepsy? One of the important clinical use is the Lennox-Gastaut syndrome. This is one of a syndrome which is childhood onset, and it can produce a recurrent attacks of the seizures, which are associated with the both tonic as well as atonic epilepsy. And this syndrome can also be associated with the loss of memory and gradual neuronal disorders, so which should be immediately treated. In such condition, cannabidiol can be given in order to treat this Lennox-Gastaut syndrome. And another syndrome is the Dravet syndrome. This is one of a syndrome that is present in the infants, and it is one of an infantile myoclonic epilepsy, which also present with the recurrent attacks of the myoclonic seizures within the children. And this Dravet syndrome is observed in the infants of less than 1 year, and the symptoms can be observed throughout the life period. So cannabidiol can be given in the infants as well as the adults who are suffering with these two types of syndromes. So that's about this cannabidiol, which is one of a useful drug in the treatment of epilepsy. It can also have the other actions like the analgesic, anxiolytic, muscle relaxant activities, but it's mainly indicated for the treatment of epilepsy where the safety is highly established. Cannabidiol acts as an antagonist on the cannabinoid receptors like both C1 and CB2 receptors. And apart from these actions, it can also block the TRPV1 ion channels, GPR55 receptors, it can stimulate the 5-HT1A receptors, and it can also modify the other signalings like it can inhibit the mTOR pathway, and it can increase the ROS, and it can also directly block the calcium channels, and It can inhibit the uptake of the neurotransmitters like norepinephrine, dopamine, glycine, and it can also inhibit the cellular uptake of the enantiomide. By all of these actions, it can produce various pharmacological effects, but it is mainly used in the treatment of epilepsy like Lennox-Gastaut syndrome and Dravet syndrome.